So how can you make money in sports photography? Easy. Just sell all your gear. Just kidding. All jokes aside, let's get serious after the intro. Hey there, you guys. Happy New Year. I am Jerry Lai, and welcome back to my sports photography channel. For those of you joining me for the very first time, I currently serve as the Director of Content and Photography at USA Today Sports, and I have been fortunate enough to have been in the photojournalism industry for the past 17 years. And my goal for the channel is to help you become a better sports photographer. If you think that I could help you out, hit the like button and subscribe. Today's topic is one that I know everybody wants to learn about, and it's how to make more money in sports photography. And no, it doesn't involve giving up and selling all of your gear, but it does involve thinking about three things that will help you along your path to making more money in sports photography. The very first and possibly most important tip that I can give you about making money in sports photography is that it's not all about shooting the pros. And yes, I do admit, as somebody who does shoot almost exclusively in pro arenas, there is a little bit of a cachet to saying, you know, I only shoot the Cubs, White Sox, Bulls, Bears, and Blackhawks. But it's really only a very small piece of the sports photography pie. For every professional team photographer out there, there's maybe tens or hundreds of college team photographers. Likewise, for every newspaper or wire service photographer, there are probably also tens or hundreds of prep team photographers and prep league photographers out there. Be sure to also keep in mind that all jobs aren't necessarily at the top of the pyramid either. And when it comes to money, it's not even a pyramid at all. It's perhaps more like a cube. The folks shooting pro level are not necessarily making any more money than those who are shooting quote unquote beneath them. Yes, there may not be as much of a wow factor to it, but it doesn't make those photographers any more or less successful. Using myself as an example, in the mid 2000s, I had two primary paying clients, the Associated Press and Prep Sports Online. The AP needs no introduction. I shot baseball, basketball, football, and a multitude of other sports for them. Prep Sports Online, however, was a high school sports agency that hired local photographers to be team photographers at local schools. I shot baseball, basketball, football, and a multitude of other sports for them. So it was the exact same task. Now, how much did I make per game at the AP? $200. And how much did I make per game with PSO? That's right, the same. Now, unfortunately, PSO, as far as I know, no longer exists. However, other companies continue to operate in the space below that pro and college level. So again, you might not necessarily get that wow factor when telling your family and friends what you do for a living, but you may find just as much success, at least if you're measuring in dollars and cents. My second tip that'll help you potentially make more money in sports photography is one that you've heard me talk about on this channel before. And that is, don't continue to shoot the same thing that everybody else is shooting. Yes, of course, when you're at a game, you still need to fulfill your primary objective. And if that is indeed to photograph and cover the story of the game, then yes, absolutely be sure you're pointing the camera in the right place to get that game-winning touchdown. But what if you have plenty of time between plays? Or if the game is a blowout and continuing to shoot the action doesn't really contribute to the story? Well, these are the appropriate times to try to find some shots away from the action. And what I mean by this exactly is consider looking for environmental things around the game. For example, wide angle scene setters or stadium overall views. You can also look to photograph players that are off the ball. Think of players getting set in their ready positions, or overlooked players such as linemen in football. Now, what exactly is the point of photographing these things? Well, let's say that you work for a photo agency. Yes, the agency may make money by selling game recaps and stories to sports sites, but they'll also sell feature photos to match articles such as stories about specific venues, or sell portraits or off-the-ball action photos that highlight draft or trade rumor articles. And this is where you, as a photographer, can potentially make some extra money by shooting some of the off-the-ball imagery. You see, this is the kind of stuff that I find that most photographers don't bother taking the time to shoot. I will also admit that sometimes this stuff isn't exactly the most fun stuff to shoot. I mean, think about it. Let's say I'm in a basketball game and LeBron James is in town. Everybody, and I mean everybody, photographs LeBron. And why not? It's LeBron. And I get it. LeBron is a superstar and will always be a story in every game. But do you know which athlete is the most searched for athlete on every sports agency's website? Yeah, you guessed it. It is LeBron. Good luck being the one that created the single iconic image of LeBron out of 135,000. Now, how about being the one that creates an image of Pro Bowl lineman Rashawn Slater of the LA Chargers? You only have to compete with 100 other images. Put it another way, do I want to be the one that has a teeny tiny chance of being the one that sells the photo that becomes a LeBron James trading card? Or the pretty big chance that I'm going to be the one that gets the commemorative Pro Bowl trading card of Rashawn Slater? I'll take my chances with Slater. Again, yes, you want to be sure you're at a game and fulfilling your primary objective of covering the story of the game, but don't forget to stop and look around during the downtimes or when the story of the game allows you to get away and photograph this off-the-ball action. You may find that doing so will be rewarding in the long haul. Now, my third and final tip for making more money in sports photography is to find your niche. Again, everybody wants to shoot the pros, and there's nothing wrong with that. But at this level of sport, photographers can be more or less interchangeable. Of course, every company will have go-to photographers and those that are a level beyond. But by and large, everyone looks at and shoots the same exact thing. So how do you stand out? Be a specialist. For example, in their heyday, Sports Illustrated had photographers who could do it all. But each one of their staffers seemed to have a specialty sport that they were particularly strong at. For example, they had multiple ice hockey photographers who were known for pioneering unique angles to place remote cameras. Same for basketball as well. But it doesn't have to be limited to mainstream sports like basketball or hockey. Think about all the other sports that exist out there. For example, there are ski photographers who travel the entire world circuit every winter. I've been to 7 Olympic Games and I'm still amazed at each one where I meet a sports specialist. Can you believe I've met equestrian and even rock climbing specialists at the Olympics? Yeah, seriously, rock climbing. So perhaps think about shooting sports or activities that you have an interest or knowledge in, and really try to tap into that market. And who knows, maybe, just maybe, that is your ticket to Paris 2024. Breakdancing, anybody? Now, let's say you're not going to become a sports specialist, or none of those really interest you. You can still set yourself apart from everybody else by being known as a creative. Don't forget that when the opportunity presents itself, you can photograph from different angles in the stadium or chase the light. Now, just like the off-the-ball action, most photographers won't bother to put in the extra steps to hunt this content down. By putting in these extra steps, you can sort of become known as a hustler who really hunts for these unique opportunities, and this will give you the edge on other photographers who safely corral themselves in the photo pens the entire game. Trust me when I say that editors like myself do notice this day in, day out, and as a result, you'll likely get more calls from us, which result in more opportunities to not only shoot, but of course, to make more money. So anyways, those are my three tips that you should always keep in mind that will help improve your chances of making money in sports photography. Just as a recap, number one, don't focus solely on shooting professional sports. Number two, photograph scenes in action away from the ball. And number three, find your niche or be creative. Thank you very much as always for watching. If you found this video helpful or entertaining, I would really appreciate it if you hit that like button or subscribed. Don't forget to also ring the notification bell so that you can be alerted as to when new content comes out. I try to make videos every few weeks or so. Thanks again for stopping by today. Stay safe, happy new year, and I'll see you all again in the next video. Bye now.